All right, guys, this is round two, and we're going to talk about the basic truth of the money game. So the biggest epidemic in this country, in my opinion, besides people's weight and heart disease, is their financial intelligence. For whatever reason, you can get a full degree from the University of Alabama or Florida State or become a Harvard graduate and not know anything about how the finance world works, that you need to get a broker or a loan officer or whatever to help you out. Financial intelligence is probably one of the biggest traits you need to have as an entrepreneur or a lifeaneur, right? And so I'll give you the first example of what people feel is the best loan in the game, but really has been the reason and the foundation for why the banking industry has taken off and makes billions of dollars a quarter every year on your money, right? Now, I'm a banker, okay? And you want to buy a house. So you're going to try and procure a mortgage from me, the banker, right? I'm going to give you a simple analogy. I want you to write this down. If you need a PDF, we'll make a PDF in the bottom of it so you can click and get the analogy, right? This is called an amortized loan. If you don't know what that is, look it up on YouTube or get more information on my website, right? I'm going to give you a $100,000 loan, okay? You're going to pay me back over 30 years, okay? It's going to be an amortized style loan, but I'm only going to charge you 3% interest, okay? You're going to pay me $1,000 a month for the next 30 years, okay? And for the first 5 years, I'm going to take 90% to 85% of your monthly premium that you're paying me, your monthly mortgage payment, as interest. So in this equation, right, you in 5 years, you would have spent roughly $60,000 paying back a $100,000 mortgage, and only $12,000 of it actually went to interest. The other $48,000 of it came into my pocket. I'll say it again, $100,000 is what I gave you. Over 5 years, you gave me $60,000 in return. $48,000 went in my pocket. $12,000 went back to paying off the loan, right? Over the lifelong value of this loan, you are going to pay $360,000 if you don't refi. Let me say that again, if you don't refinance. Because what the banks do is once you hit year 4, 5, and 6, they're going to start marketing you to refinance and pull out that equity out of your home and put 10 grand in your pocket. It's really your own money. You don't realize this. It's your own money. You paid me $48,000. Your house went up in value 10 grand. Let me give you 10 of the 48,000 that you just gave me in interest, and let me start the amortization process all over again. Which means now in next 5 years, the 90%, 85% of your payments again, which might be $1,100 or $950, it went down a little bit, put a little bit of money in your pocket, went down a decimal in interest. But the amortization is where the banks make all their money. So student loans, this is why you'll see people that have $100,000 in student loans. And they will literally make that payment to Navient or to Fannie Mae or all those different places every month for 10 years. And when they ask for their balance, it's double what they got paid for going to college in the first place. You get a $100,000 loan, you pay your payments for 10 years, and then it's $200,000 in 10 years. And it's insane. It is the worst loan in history is a student loan. You can't file bankruptcy on it. You can't write it off. You can't do any of that stuff, right? It is the worst loan in history. Get rid of amortization. If you want to learn how to get rid of amortization, look it up on YouTube. It's free, or go to the content on my website and it will show you how to do it for free. The average person that I teach how to save money and how to beat an amortized loan saves $100,000, $200,000, $300,000 $1,000 in interest, and the banks absolutely hate me for it, but I'd rather have the money go in your pocket to start learning how to do self-education and putting money back in your pocket rather than giving it to the banker boys who don't care about you. You decide. Thank you.